art is important for everyone, no matter your age, no matter anything. Art is one of those things that your body is going to be able to do your whole life. My name is Elizabeth Rockstad. I'm in Ada, Minnesota, and the studio is Studio 413. My family's very encouraging as far as art goes. I had grandmothers who were painters, and my mother is very creative. We just kind of always made stuff as a kid. In school, I kind of enjoyed it, and it kind of took off from there. That's kind of what actually got me into teaching art as well. I went to Morehead State, and I got my K-12 art education degree. I taught for about 15 or 16 years. I opened the studio in 2011. The business came about because I was actually with some friends at a little resort. The lady had a very small paint your own pottery little studio. So we went in and each made something small. And then I just remember after that kind of always having that in the back of my head. Studio 413 comes from Philippians 4:13, which is, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. That's my verse for life in general. So I thought it was quite fitting for starting up a business and putting my trust there. And it's worked out really well. What drew me to Mosaics, I started it in college, but then once I opened the studio, I just was able to have more time to work on it. The mosaic process is creating a design, creating artwork using just fill in the blank. You can use just about any material. I use primarily glass, ceramic tile, and now a little more beads and some stonework too. It's cutting the tile and then gluing them on. I'll attach my glue to the surface and then attach my tiles to the glue. Once that glue dries, then you grout. It's like frosting a cake. You just kind of smear it over everything, wipe off all the grout, and the tiles come through. But depending on the pieces, there's a lot of cleaning and shining and buffing and all of that stuff that you can do later on. In fact, there's some pieces where I have honestly clocked more hours cleaning than I did making it. And then depending on where it's going, you seal it or you don't seal it. That's basically it. What draws me to the mosaics is more the physicality of it. I love to work with my hands. It's the tactile part of it for me. I love texture, I love color, and with mosaics you get everything. I like the idea of reusing things that people maybe discard or don't see as important or don't see the value in. With mosaics, you can use it. I kind of joke that's the good and bad thing with mosaics is you can mosaic almost anything, you can mosaic with almost anything. Bad side, you can mosaic almost anything, and you can mosaic with almost anything. I tend to collect because everything I see, or if something breaks, I think, oh, I can use it. When you're working with all of those things and being blessed to be in a small town, at least once a week, if not more, someone comes in and tells me, I have this that we're just going to throw away. Do you want it? That idea of reusing is important to me. One of my favorites is probably a Four Seasons window. I did an artist in residency at West Acres in 2019. I think I like it because when I started it, I didn't like it. I just kept going with it. And then as it progressed, I liked it more and more. And then when I finished it, it's kind of one of my favorite pieces now. The piece I'm working on now is a commission piece that is going up in Crookston at Riverview Clinic. I'm making 10 large-scale mandala. I kind of call them like lollipop flowers. So there's a stem and then a mandala for the flower on top with leaves. It's probably the largest project I've done as far as commission-wise. The commission work I have done have been windows. I kind of started out mosaicing, it's called glass-on-glass mosaic windows. Those are just old barn windows or a window from great-grandma's farm home. But now I've done everything from a deer head, not a huge one, but just I had never really done a three-dimensional animal, so to speak. And honestly, like the challenge and just coming up with the idea and coming up with a way to create it, I wouldn't say I like more, but that is an aspect of commission work that I do enjoy. I don't want to say I'm a people pleaser, but when it comes to commissions, it's important to me. I want them to look at it and just feel joy from it. I think because I feel like I've done it all my life, it's almost second nature. So it just kind of feels natural. It just kind of feels like that's what I was made to do, meant to do. You hear stories and you know people who go to a job and don't enjoy it. And I just think, oh, thank you. Thank you so much that I get to do what I get to do, because I can't imagine doing anything else.
Funded by the Minnesota Arts and Cultural Heritage Fund, with money from the vote of the people of Minnesota on November 4th, 2008. And by the members of Prairie Public.